everything in here. We couldn't handle that. Your spirit couldn't even handle the full brilliance of God, because we have not spent enough time in that presence. We're just a small facet, a small reflection of the totality of the light that God is. But the more we learn to walk in this light, the brighter that light gets, the stronger we get in this. So what's this got to do with translation? It's got everything to do with it. As when Elijah visited me, you see, Rosh Hashanah 2 years before that, the Lord had presented me with a key. I knew the key had to do with portals and doorways, had to do with translation. And I held on to it and said, I know, God, you'll tell me how to use this, what this is for. Well, he said, keys are for doors. So, you know, how do you use it? Well, we put it in the door and open it. But I wait. So now, after I finally was practicing with Elijah, I won't go into all of that, he stood in front of me, and I'm standing there as a being of light, and he has my key. And I thought, how did you get that? You're a thief. And he said, put out your hand. And my hand was light at the time. And he put the key into my hand, this key that was made of light that God had given me, and it dissolved into me. And I was, what was that? He said, well, you're the same frequency of light. You are the key. Oh, shifted everything. Where I had struggled before and contended and tried to understand, I now had resolution. I don't have to struggle with this. I am light. The key is in me because of the light. Door open. And it's like that. Door open, and it's like that. I practiced that at the school in Chennai. You know what happened? We do practice sessions. People are engaging. And I stood on the platform and said, okay, I'm the key. Door open. And instantly a portal opened. And that's what the students saw, and they all came up and started interacting. It's that simple. Let me ask you a question. Do we all agree that God is omnipresent? And he's omnipotent. He knows all things, and he's everywhere at once. Okay, you're dead and your life is hidden in Christ. If he's everywhere at once, how difficult is it to get from here to there? I'm not saying you're omnipresent, you're not. But he is, and because you're in him, you can go anywhere. Like that. Heaven to earth. Around the earth. Go sit down on a moon rock and talk with Jesus. Okay. Do you know light exhibits an uncanny, unexplainable awareness or consciousness of its surroundings? The physics of this is they had done a split light test. They take a photon of light and they put it through a box. They shine this light and it goes through a box like this and it comes back together. It has a consciousness. Interesting. So in light there is life. Even the created light has life. Never mind God who is light. I mean, we could go on and on. There is something about light God wants to communicate to us. Because Isaiah 60 goes on. I mean, I've got all sorts of physics things here. Here's another thing. Because light is always present along the trajectory to which it's sent. In other words, when light started at the creation, it continues. And it's all the way along that trajectory. So in light, there is no time or space because it's outside of time. So 1888 is happening right now. .1300 is happening right now. .1200, because outside of time, light is at every point of its trajectory. In other words, now. That's a familiar word in Scripture. Now faith is. Now God is. God is now at every point of human history. John on the island of Patmos steps out of the natural realm into the eternal realm.